Mosaic, a daily news program from Link TV, presents a selection of news reports from independent and state-controlled broadcasters from throughout the Middle East.
Today, the Iraqi police confirmed that four Iraqi soldiers were killed and four others were wounded when an explosive device detonated in the city of Samarra, north of Baghdad. The deteriorating security situation coincided with the festivities of Eid al-Adha. On the occasion of this blessed holiday, Iraqis are hoping for peace in their country. The holiday in Iraq has a different meaning. It is the only ray of light amidst all the darkness of violence and an uncertain political environment. Earlier this morning, Baghdad's streets seemed to be deserted, except for a few cars who dared to embark on an early morning trip. At about noon, activity resumed in the city. Our first stop was at the Maidan Square in Rusafa. Boys and girls played and ran around in the park, their eyes reflecting a determination to live and celebrate the joy of life, even if their future in this new Iraq seems uncertain. Shukar is a 14-year-old boy. He, however, is an exception to the rule. He demonstrated his early political awareness when he took me aside and confided in me that he is a Sadr supporter.
Praise be to God. Hopefully the elections will take place and the explosions and car bombs will stop. If God is willing, the terrorists will leave the country.
The residents of Baghdad seem to be on bad terms with happiness, as the festivities of Eid are overshadowed with assassinations and explosions that rattle the city as election day nears. Meanwhile, strict security measures are being imposed.
We are hoping for security and stability for the Iraqis. We are dedicated to serving the Iraqi people who are suffering.
The Azamiya neighborhood, with its Sunni majority, was our second stop. People here don't talk very much. The residents are overwhelmed with the elections amidst the surrounding controversy created by the various political and ethnic parties who are trying to gain their votes. Our last stop was at the Harathiya neighborhood in central Baghdad, which is parallel to the Green Zone. We were received by a prominent Iraqi family who welcomed us with the traditional warm Iraqi hospitality. In this house, family members gathered around the dining table of Haj Mutlak, greeting each other on the occasion of the holiday, which is bringing this family together. Family gatherings are less possible in this new Iraq.
We wish peace for the Islamic world and Iraq on the occasion of the blessed Eid al-Adha. If God is willing, this crisis will end for the sake of Prophet Muhammad.